We're so excited. He is not only an internationally known recording artist, he's also a beloved radio and television personality. Welcome, John Tesh. How are you?
I'm so great. You know, we watch you guys all the time. So, in fact, I've been watching since Mark was like 9.
Thank you. Long time.
Yeah.
It's so good to see you. You were so nice. You actually hosted Entertainment Tonight for years, and you were nice enough to send us the most fabulously 80s intro. So let's take a look back.
Enter a world of excitement, where fantasy comes to life, where the stakes are high and secrets lie. For your entertainment tonight, enter a world of excitement, enter the world of entertainment tonight.
Weeknights at 7 on King 5.
I think we got John Bon Jovi to sing that.
We're at the 80s, great.
And you actually had a reunion with Mary Hart recently, right?
Yeah, a couple of weeks ago. Yeah, what happened was the publicist sent them the book and said, hey, can you do 30 seconds on this book that John wrote? And Mary said, I want to read it, and said, let me do an interview with you. And then E.T. said, why don't you take over for the day? So people were freaking out. It's like, what is it, 1984 again?
Right.
Yeah. Gosh. Did you enjoy doing that at the time? Was it fun?
It was great fun.
Exciting.
Yeah, it was. In fact, I only worked for nothing like your job. I worked like 4 hours a day.
Mm-hmm.
And then Paramount let me use their recording studios. I was able to do music at the same time.
Nice.
Yeah, it was really great.
There are so many things I want to talk about in this book. It's hard to even decide which question I want to ask you, but I didn't realize that you were actually homeless for a point in North Carolina, right?
Wow. Yeah, I wanted to be a musician my whole life. My dad was one of the vice presidents of Hanes Underwear, and we got free underwear for 18 years. Yeah, in fact, if you want to just give me your sizes, so I have a connection. Anyway, so he wanted me to follow in his footsteps because he figured I would starve to death. And so he enrolled me at NC State in textile chemistry. I tried it for a while, and then I got bit by the radio television bug. I took one of those courses. So I changed my major without telling my parents, and one of my professors wouldn't sign the drop ad card because it was after the drop ad date. So I took advice from a fraternity brother, signed the card myself. They caught me. I got suspended. I broke the honor code. They gave me an F for the course, and then my dad threw me out of the house.
So,
at 19 and a half years old, I was homeless living in a park in North Carolina, breaking concrete with a shovel on a construction crew. Yeah.
Wow. That's amazing. I mean, there are so many amazing things in this book, and we're going to talk
about that. 36 months later, I was anchoring the news at WCBS TV in New York City.
Oh
so that's
God.
And,
wow.
And then and when I was getting ready to write the book, I was like, I thought that was 10 years.
Right.
And it ended up being just 3 years. So it's the story of the process of getting out of the tent.
Well, and not only that, and you survived a business, by the way, in entertainment, which is not easy, but you also survived terminal cancer. Tell us about that.
Yeah, 2015, I got a horrible diagnosis. And if it wasn't for my GP, Dr. Steve Galen, and my wife Connie, I wouldn't have made it. Originally I had faith for they gave me like 18 months. They said get your affairs in order. It was a rare form of prostate cancer. They didn't make any blood markers, right? And so originally we had faith for the doctors, and I went to MD Anderson and also Johns Hopkins and Northwestern, but it just kept the cancer was relentless. Mm-hmm. And during that period of time, Connie Selica, my wife, and I, we discovered these healing scriptures in the Bible, including Mark 11:23 and also Proverbs 18:21, which are very valuable right now during the coronavirus
thing,
by
the way.
And when they wanted to do the last treatment, which was they wanted to irradiate my pelvis 57 times, basically faith was born because we had this training in these healing scriptures. And Mark 11:23 is basically, whoever says to this mountain, be removed and be cast into the sea, and does not doubt in his heart, but believes that what he says will be done, shall have what he says. And the moment we get the revelation for that, faith was born, and I was healed, and I've been clear of cancer for years.
Wow, unbelievable.
Yeah. It was supernatural. I mean, unbelievable is right.
You know, there's so much more I want to talk to you about. Unfortunately, we're like out of time, but this is amazing. Like even just the back part of the book is amazing. It's called Relentless. And John's new book, Relentless, Unleashing a Life of Purpose, Grit, and Faith is out now. John, thank you so much for coming in.
Thanks, it's great to see you guys again. Yeah,
good to see you.
An amazing story, thanks again.
Hey, if they give us one of those rating books, you guys are number one.
I'm telling
you. We'll work on that.
So good to see you, I'm glad you're doing well.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you.